This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The Appalachian Mountains I, Appalachian, or Appalachian, French, Les Appalaches, often called the Appalachians, are a system of mountains in eastern North America. The Appalachians first formed roughly 480 million years ago during the Ordovician period. It once reached elevations similar to those of the Alps and the Rocky Mountains before naturally occurring erosion. The Appalachian chain is a barrier to east-west travel, as it forms a series of alternating ridgelines and valleys oriented in opposition to most roads running east or west. Definitions vary on the precise boundaries of the Appalachians. The United States Geological Survey USGS defines the Appalachian Highlands Physiographic Division as consisting of 13 provinces: the Atlantic Coast Uplands, Eastern Newfoundland Atlantic, Maritime Acadian Highlands, Maritime Plain, Notre Dame and Megantic Mountains, Western Newfoundland Mountains, Piedmont, Blue Ridge, Valley and Ridge, St. Lawrence Valley, Appalachian Plateaus, New England Province, and the Adirondack Provinces. A common variant definition does not include the Adirondack Mountains, which geologically belong to the Grenville Orogeny and have a different geological history from the rest of the Appalachians. Contents 1 Overview 11 Origin of the name. 2 Geography 21 Regions 22 Chief Summits 23 Drainage 3 Geology 31 Mineral Resources 4 Ecology 41 Flora 42 Fauna 5 See also 6 Footnotes 7 References 8 Sources 9 Further Reading 10 External Links Overview The range is mostly located in the United States but extends into southeastern Canada, forming a zone from 100 to 300. Newfoundland 1500. Orbis Partis Nova et Exactissima Descriptio while exploring inland along the northern coast of Florida in 1528, the members of the Narvaez expedition, including Alvar Núñez Cabeza de Vaca, found a Native American village near present-day Tallahassee, Florida whose name they transcribed as Apalchin or Appalachian. The name was soon altered by the Spanish to Apalache and used as a name for the tribe and region spreading well inland to the north. Pánfilo de Narváez's expedition first entered Apalache territory on June 15, 1528, and applied the name now spelled Appalachian. It is the fourth oldest surviving European place name in the U.S. after the De Soto expedition in 1540. Spanish cartographers began to apply the name of the tribe to the mountains themselves. The first cartographic appearance of Apalachian is on Diego Gutiérrez's map of 1562. The first use for the mountain range is the map of Jacques Lemoyne de Morgues in 1565. The name was not commonly used for the whole mountain range until the late 19th century. A competing and often more popular name was the Allegheny Mountains, Alleghenies, and even Allegania. In the early 19th century, Washington Irving proposed renaming the United States either Appalachia or Allegania in U.S. dialects in the southern regions of the Appalachians. The word is pronounced Eplatnz, with the third syllable sounding like latch. In northern parts of the mountain range, it is pronounced Eplatnz, or Eplatnz. The third syllable is like lay, and the fourth chins or shins. There is often great debate between the residents of the regions as to which pronunciation is the more correct one. Elsewhere, a commonly accepted pronunciation for the adjective Appalachian is Eplaten, with the last two syllables ian pronounced as in the word Romanian. Geography regions Blue Ridge Mountains. The whole system may be divided into three great sections. Northern, the northern section runs from the Canadian province of Newfoundland and Labrador to the Hudson River. It includes the Long Range Mountains and Aniopsquatch Mountains on the island of Newfoundland, Chic Chalk Mountains and Notre Dame Range in Quebec and New Brunswick, scattered elevations and small ranges elsewhere in Nova Scotia and New Brunswick, the Longfellow Mountains in Maine, the White Mountains in New Hampshire, the Green Mountains in Vermont, and the Berkshires in Massachusetts and Connecticut, the Metacomet Ridge Mountains in Connecticut and South Central Massachusetts, although contained within the Appalachian Province, is a younger system and not geologically associated with the Appalachians. The Monteregion Hills, which cross the Green Mountains in Quebec, are also unassociated with the Appalachian Central. The central section goes from the Hudson Valley to the New River Great Kanawha running through Virginia and West Virginia. It comprises, excluding various minor groups, the valley ridges between the Allegheny Front of the Allegheny Plateau and the Great Appalachian Valley, the New York-New Jersey Highlands, the Taconic Mountains in New York, and a large portion of the Blue Ridge Southern. The southern section runs from the New River onwards. It consists of the prolongation elevation of the Blue Ridge, which is divided into the Western Blue Ridge or Anaka Front and the Eastern Blue Ridge Front, the Ridge and Valley Appalachians, and the Cumberland Plateau Bald Mountains. The Adirondack Mountains in New York are sometimes considered part of the Appalachian Chain but, geologically speaking, are a southern extension of the Laurentian Mountains of Canada. Shaded relief map of the Cumberland Plateau and Ridge and Valley Appalachians on the Virginia-West Virginia border. In addition to the true folded mountains, known as the Ridge and Valley Province, the area of dissected plateau to the north and west of the mountains is usually grouped with the Appalachians. This includes the Catskill Mountains of southeastern New York, the Poconos in Pennsylvania, and the Allegheny Plateau of southwestern New York, western Pennsylvania, eastern Ohio, and northern West Virginia. This same plateau is known as the Cumberland Plateau in southern West Virginia, eastern Kentucky, western Virginia, eastern Tennessee, and northern Alabama. The dissected plateau area, while not actually made up of geological mountains, is popularly called mountains, especially in eastern Kentucky and West Virginia, and while the ridges are not high, the terrain is extremely rugged in Ohio and New York. Some of the plateau has been glaciated, which has rounded off the sharp ridges, and filled the valleys to some extent. The glaciated regions are usually referred to as hill country rather than mountains. The Appalachian region is generally considered the geographical divide between the eastern seaboard of the United States and the Midwest region of the country. The Eastern Continental Divide follows the Appalachian Mountains from Pennsylvania to Georgia. The Appalachian Trail is a 2,175-mile 3,500 chief summits. The Appalachian Belt includes, with the ranges enumerated above, the plateaus sloping southward to the Atlantic Ocean in New England, and southeastward to the border of the coastal plain through the central and southern Atlantic states, and on the northwest, the Allegheny and Cumberland plateaus declining toward the Great Lakes and the interior plains. A remarkable feature of the belt is the longitudinal chain of broad valleys, including the Great Appalachian Valley, which in the southerly sections divides the mountain system into two unequal portions, but in the northernmost lies west of all the ranges possessing typical Appalachian features, and separates them from the Adirondack group. The mountain system has no axis of dominating altitudes, but in every portion the summits rise to rather uniform heights, and, especially in the central section, the various ridges and intermontane valleys have the same trend as the system itself. None of the summits reaches the region of perpetual snow. Old fault exposed by Roadkit near Hazleton, Pennsylvania, along Interstate 81. Such faults are common in the folded Appalachians. Mountains of the Long Range in Newfoundland reach heights of nearly 2,700. 4,000. Virginia cliffs overlooking the New River near Gauley Bridge, West Virginia. The Blue Ridge Mountains, rising in southern Pennsylvania and they're known as South Mountain, attain elevations of about 2,000. Near the Tennessee-North Carolina border, Mount Mitchell 6,684. Which crosses the mountainous belt just north of the New River in Virginia. South of the New River, rivers head into the Blue Ridge, cross the higher Anakas, receive important tributaries from the Great Valley, and traversing the Cumberland Plateau in spreading gorges water gaps, escape by way of the Cumberland River and the Tennessee River rivers to the Ohio River and the Mississippi River, and thence to the Gulf of Mexico in the central section. North of the New River, the rivers, rising in or just beyond the valley ridges, flow through Great Gorges to the Great Valley, and then across the Blue Ridge to tidal estuaries penetrating the coastal plain via the Roanoke River, James River, Potomac River, and Susquehanna River in the northern section. The height of land lies on the inland side of the mountainous belt, and thus the main lines of drainage run from north to south, exemplified by the Hudson River. However, the valley through which the Hudson River flows was cut by the gigantic glaciers of the Ice Ages, the same glaciers that deposited their terminal moraines in southern New York and formed the East-West Long Island Geology. Main article, Geology of the Appalachians. USGS Appalachian Zones in the United States. A look at rocks exposed in today's Appalachian Mountains reveals elongated belts of folded and thrust faulted marine sedimentary rocks, volcanic rocks and slivers of ancient ocean floor, which provides strong evidence that these rocks were deformed during plate collision, the birth of the Appalachian Ranges, some 480. By the end of the Mesozoic era, the Appalachian Mountains had been eroded to an almost flat plain. It was not until the region was uplifted during the Cenozoic era that the distinctive topography of the present formed uplift rejuvenated the streams, which rapidly responded by cutting downward into the ancient bedrock. Some streams flowed along weak layers that define the folds and faults created many millions of years earlier. Other streams downcut so rapidly that they cut right across the resistant folded rocks of the mountain core, carving canyons across rock layers and geologic structures. Mineral resources. The Appalachian Mountains contain major deposits of anthracite coal as well as bituminous coal. In the Folded Mountains, the coal is in metamorphosed form as anthracite, represented by the coal region of northeastern Pennsylvania, the bituminous coal fields of western Pennsylvania, western Maryland, southeastern Ohio, eastern Kentucky, southwestern Virginia, and West Virginia contain the sedimentary form of coal. The mountain top removal method of coal mining, in which entire mountain tops are removed, is currently threatening vast areas and ecosystems of the Appalachian Mountain region. The 1859 discovery of commercial quantities of petroleum in the Appalachian Mountains of western Pennsylvania started the modern United States petroleum industry. Recent discoveries of commercial natural gas deposits in the Marcellus Shale Formation and Utica Shale Formations have once again focused oil industry attention on the Appalachian Basin. Some plateaus of the Appalachian Mountains contain metallic minerals such as iron and zinc. Ecology. Further information: Appalachian Blue Ridge Forests, Appalachian Mixed Mesophytic Forests, Appalachian Temperate Rainforest, New England, Acadian Forests, and Appalachian Bogs. Flora view from Mount Mitchell at 6,684. Highest elevations of the southern Appalachians, as in North Carolina and Tennessee. In the central Appalachians, it is usually confined above 3,000. Does well in soils with a pH as high as 6. Shenandoah National Park, Eastern or Canada. Hemlock Suga canadensis is another important evergreen needle-leaf conifer that grows along the Appalachian chain from north to south, but is confined to lower elevations than red spruce and the firs. It generally occupies richer and less acidic soils than the spruce and firs and is characteristic of deep, shaded and moist mountain valleys and coves. It is, unfortunately, subject to the hemlock woolly adelgid Adelgis sugae, an introduced insect that is rapidly extirpating it as a forest tree less abundant, and restricted to the southern Appalachians, is Carolina hemlock Suga caroliniana. Like Canada hemlock, this tree suffers severely from the hemlock woolly adelgid. Several species of pines characteristic of the Appalachians are eastern white pine Pinus strabus, Virginia pine Pinus virginiana, pitch pine Pinus rigida, table mountain pine Pinus pungens, and shortleaf pine Pinus echinata. Red pine Pinus resinosa is a boreal species that forms a few high elevation outliers as far south as West Virginia. All of these species except white pine tend to occupy sandy, rocky, poor soil sites, which are mostly acidic in character. White pine, a large species valued for its timber, tends to do best in rich, moist soil, either acidic or alkaline in character. Pitch pine is also at home in acidic, boggy soil, and table mountain pine may occasionally be found in this habitat as well. Shortleaf pine is generally found in warmer habitats and at lower elevations than the other species. All the species listed do best in open or lightly shaded habitats, although white pine also thrives in shady coves, valleys, and on floodplains. The view from Craggy Gardens on the Blue Ridge Parkway. The Appalachians are characterized by a wealth of large, beautiful deciduous broadleaf hardwood trees. Their occurrences are best summarized and described in E. Lucy Braun's 1950 classic, Deciduous Forests of Eastern North America. Macmillan, New York. The most diverse and richest forests are the mixed mesophytic or medium moisture types, which are largely confined to rich, moist montane soils of the southern and central Appalachians, particularly in the Cumberland and Allegheny Mountains, but also thrive in the southern Appalachian coves. Characteristic canopy species are white basswood Tilia heterophylla, yellow buckeye Asculus octandra, sugar maple Acer saccharum, American beech Fagus grandifolia, tulip tree Liriodendron tulipifera, white ash Fraxinus americana, and yellow birch Betula alleghanensis. Other common trees are red maple Acer rubrum, shagbark and bitternut hickories Caria ovata and C. cordiformis, and black or sweet birch Betula lenta. Small understory trees and shrubs include flowering dogwood Cornus florida, hop hornbeam Austria virginiana, witch hazel Hamamelis virginiana, and spicebush Landera benzoin. There are also hundreds of perennial and annual herbs, among them such herbal and medicinal plants as American ginseng Panax quinquefolius, goldenseal hydrastis canadensis, bloodroot Sanguinaria canadensis, and black cohosh Cymocyphaga racemosa. The foregoing trees, shrubs and herbs are also more widely distributed in less rich mesic forests that generally occupy coves, stream valleys and flood plains throughout the southern and central Appalachians. At low and intermediate elevations in the northern Appalachians and at higher elevations of the central and southern Appalachians, these diverse mesic forests give way to less diverse northern hardwoods, with canopies dominated only by American beech beech, sugar maple, American basswood Tilia americana and yellow birch, and with far fewer species of shrubs and herbs, drier and rockier uplands and ridges are occupied by oak chestnut type forests dominated by a variety of oaks, Quercus spp, Hickories caria spp, and, in the past, by the American chestnut Castanea dentata. The American chestnut was virtually eliminated as a canopy species by the introduced fungal chestnut blight Cryphonectria parasitica, but lives on as sapling-sized sprouts that originate from roots, which are not killed by the fungus in present-day forest canopies. Chestnut has been largely replaced by oaks. The oak forests of the southern and central Appalachians consist largely of black, northern red, white, chestnut and scarlet oaks, Quercus velutina, Q. rubra, Q. alba, Q. prenus and Q. coccinea, and hickories, such as the pignut caria glabra, in particular the richest forests, which grade into mesic types, usually in coves and on gentle slopes, have dominantly white and northern red oaks, while the driest sites are dominated by chestnut oak, or sometimes by scarlet or northern red oaks. In the northern Appalachians, the oaks, except for white and northern red, drop out, while the latter extends farthest north. Great laurel thicket in the Pisgah National Forest. The oak forests generally lack the diverse small tree, shrub and herb layers of mesic forest. Shrubs are generally ericaceous, and include the evergreen mountain laurel Kalmia latifolia, various species of blueberries Vaccinium spp, black huckleberry Galicacea baccata, a number of deciduous rhododendrons azaleas, and smaller heaths such as Teaberry Gaultheria procumbens and trailing Arbutus epigea repens. The evergreen great rhododendron Rhododendron maximum is characteristic of moist stream valleys. These occurrences are in line with the prevailing acidic character of most oak forest soils. In contrast, the much rarer chinkapin oak Quercus muhlenbergi demands alkaline soils and generally grows where limestone rock is near the surface, hence no ericaceous shrubs are associated with it. The Appalachian floras also include a diverse assemblage of bryophytes, mosses and liverworts, as well as fungi. Some species are rare and or endemic, as with vascular plants. These tend to be closely related to the character of the soils and thermal environment in which they are found. Eastern deciduous forests are subject to a number of serious insect and disease outbreaks. Among the most conspicuous is that of the introduced gypsy moth Limantria disper, which infests primarily oaks, causing severe defoliation and tree mortality, but it also has the benefit of eliminating weak individuals, and thus improving the genetic stock, as well as creating rich habitat of a type through accumulation of dead wood because hardwood sprout so readily. This moth is not as harmful as the hemlock woolly adelgid. Perhaps more serious is the introduced beech bark disease complex, which includes both a scale insect Cryptococcus phagosuga and fungal components Cranberry Glades, a bog preserve in West Virginia. During the 19th and early 20th centuries, the Appalachian forests were subject to severe and destructive logging and land clearing, which resulted in the designation of the national forests and parks, as well many state protected areas. However, these and a variety of other destructive activities continue, albeit in diminished forms, and thus far only a few ecologically based management practices have taken hold. Appalachian bogs are boreal ecosystems, which occur in many places in the Appalachians, particularly the Allegheny and Blue Ridge subranges. Though popularly called bogs, many of them are technically fens. Fauna animals that characterize the Appalachian forests include five species of tree squirrels. The most commonly seen is the low to moderate elevation eastern gray squirrel Sciurus carolinensis, occupying similar habitat as the slightly larger fox squirrel Sciurus niger and the much smaller southern flying squirrel Glaucomys volans. More characteristic of cooler northern and high elevation habitat is the red squirrel Tamiosurus hudsonicus, whereas the Appalachian northern flying squirrel Glaucomys sabrinus fuscus, which closely resembles the southern flying squirrel, is confined to northern hardwood and spruce fir forests. Southern flying squirrel is familiar, as squirrels are the eastern cottontail rabbit Sylvilagus floridanus and the white-tailed deer Odocoileus virginianus. The latter in particular has greatly increased in abundance as a result of the extirpation of the eastern wolf Canis lupus lycaon and the cougar. This has led to the overgrazing and browsing of many plants of the Appalachian forests, as well as destruction of agricultural crops. Other deer include the moose Alces laces, found only in the north, and the elk Cervus canadensis, which, although once extirpated, is now making a comeback through transplantation. In the southern and central Appalachians in Quebec, the Chic-Chocs host the only population of caribou Rangifer tarandus south of the St. Lawrence River, an additional species that is common in the north but extends its range southward at high elevations to Virginia and West Virginia as the varying of snowshoe hare Lepus americanus. However, these central Appalachian populations are scattered and very small. Another species of great interest is the beaver Castor canadensis, which is showing a great resurgence in numbers after its near extirpation for its pelt. This resurgence is bringing about a drastic alteration in habitat through the construction of dams and other structures throughout the mountains. Other common forest animals are the black bear Ursus americanus, striped skunk Mephitis mephitis, raccoon Procyon lot or, woodchuck Marmota monad, bobcat Felis rufus, gray fox Erosion cinerorgenteus, red fox Vulpes vulpes, and in recent years, the coyote Canis latrans, another species favored by the advent of Europeans and the extirpation of eastern and red wolves. European boars were introduced in the early 20th century. Characteristic birds of the forest are wild turkey Meleagris gallopavocele westris, ruffed grouse Bonassa umbellus, mourning dove Zenaida macrora, common raven Corvus corax, wood duck X sponsa, great horned owl Bubo virginianus, barred owl Strix varia, screech owl Megascops asio, red-tailed hawk Bootio jamaicensis, red-shouldered hawk Bootio lineatus, and northern goshawk Accipiter gentilis, as well as a great variety of songbirds passeriforms, like the warblers. In particular, male eastern wild turkey of great importance are the many species of salamanders and, in particular, the lungless species family Plethodontidae that live in great abundance concealed by leaves and debris. On the forest floor most frequently seen, however, is the eastern or red-spotted newt Notophthalmus viridescens, whose terrestrial eft form is often encountered on the open, dry forest floor. It has been estimated that salamanders represent the largest class of animal biomass in the Appalachian forests. Frogs and toads are of lesser diversity and abundance, but the wood frog Rana sylvatica is, like the eft, commonly encountered on the dry forest floor, while a number of species of small frogs, such as spring peepers Pseudocrys crucifer, and in the forest with their calls. Salamanders and other amphibians contribute greatly to nutrient cycling through their consumption of small life forms on the forest floor and in aquatic habitats. Although reptiles are less abundant and diverse than amphibians, a number of snakes are conspicuous members of the fauna. One of the largest is the non-venomous black rat snake Elaph obsoleta obsoleta, while the common garter snake Thamnophis sertalis is among the smallest but most abundant. The American copperhead Agkistrodon contortrix and the timber rattler Crotalus horridus are venomous pit vipers. There are few lizards, but the broad-headed skink Eumaces laticeps, at up to 13. Common snapping turtle Chelydra serpentina, which occurs throughout the Appalachians. Appalachian streams are notable for their highly diverse freshwater fish life. Among the most abundant and diverse are those of the minnow family family Cyprinidae, while species of the colorful darters Persina spp are also abundant. A characteristic fish of shaded, cool Appalachian forest streams is the wild brook or speckled trout Salvelinus fontinalis, which is much sought after as a game fish. However, in past years such trout waters have been much degraded by increasing temperatures due to timber cutting, pollution from various sources, and potentially global warming. See also Flora of the Appalachian Mountains, Appalachia, Appalachian Culture, Appalachian League, Appalachian Mountain Club, Appalachian Trail. Footnotes. There are at least 8 possible pronunciations depending on 3 factors: whether the stressed vowel is e or a, whether the ch is pronounced as a fricative or an affricate t, and whether the final ia is the monophthong or the vowel sequence I. References. International Appalachian Trail Newfoundland IATNLCA, retrieved 6 November 2010. Appalachian Mountains NASA, archived from the original on 6 December 2007, retrieved 27 December 2007. Carrot. Blakey, Ron. Paleogeography and Geologic Evolution of North America. Global Plate Tectonics and Paleogeography. Northern Arizona University, archived from the original on 21 June 2008, retrieved 4 July 2008. Retrieved 19 July 2010. Further reading. Brooks, Maurice, 1965, The Appalachians, The Naturalists' America, illustrated by Lois Darling and Lo Brooks. Boston, Houghton Mifflin Company. Cottle, Harry M. 1963, Night Comes to the Cumberlands. ISBN 0-316-13212-8. Constance, George, 2004, Hollows, Peepers, and Highlanders, An Appalachian Mountain Ecology, 2nd edition, West Virginia University Press, Morgantown. 359 P. Olson, Ted, 1998, Blue Ridge Folklife. University Press of Mississippi, 211 pages, ISBN 1-57806-023-0. Reader, John. Chapter 2013, Appalachian Folkways. Coxville, University of Tennessee Press Chapters E, IV and V of Miss E. C. Semple's American History and Its Geographic Conditions Boston, 1903 Wiedensahl, Scott 2000, Mountains of the Heart, A Natural History of the Appalachians Fulcrum Publishing, 288 pages, ISBN 1-55591-139-0 Bailey Willis, The Northern Appalachians, and C. W. Hayes, The Southern Appalachians, both in National Geographic Monographs, Volume 9 Appalachian Flora and Fauna Related Journals Castanea, the Journal of the Southern Appalachian Botanical Society Banisteria, a journal devoted to the natural history of Virginia. The Journal of the Torrey Botanical Society External links media related to Appalachian Mountains at Wikimedia Commons. Find more about Appalachian Mountains at Wikipedia's sister projects. Media from Commons. Texts from Wikisource. Travel guide from Wikivoyage. Data from Wikidata. Appalachian, Blue Ridge Forests. Images at Bioimage. Svanderbiltedu slow modem version. Appalachian Mixed Mesophytic Forests. Images at Bioimage. Svanderbiltedu slow modem version. University of Kentucky Appalachian Center. Forests of the Central Appalachian Project. Detailed inventories of forest species at dozens of sites v.e. United States. History timeline. Pre-Columbian era. Colonial era. 13 colonies. Military history. Continental Congress. American Revolution War. American frontier. Federalist era. War of 1812. Territorial acquisitions. Territorial evolution. Mexican-American War. Civil War. Reconstruction era. Indian Wars. Gilded Age. Progressive Era. African American Civil Rights Movement 1865-1895. Vietnam War. Post Cold War. 1991 Present War on Terror. War in Afghanistan. Iraq War. Timeline of Modern American Conservatism. By topic. Demographic discoveries. Economic debt ceiling. Inventions before 1890-1945-1946-91. After 1991 Military postal. Technological and Industrial Geography. Territory. States. Territories. Counties. Cities, towns, and villages. Earthquakes. Extreme points. Islands. Mountains. Peaks. Ranges. Appalachian Rocky National Park Service. National Parks. Regions. East Coast. West Coast. Great Plains. Gulf. Mid-Atlantic. Midwestern. New England. Pacific. Central. Eastern. Northern. Northeastern. Northwestern. Southern. Southeastern. Southwestern. Western rivers. Colorado. Columbia. Mississippi. Missouri. Ohio. Rio Grande. Time. Water supply and sanitation. Politics. Federal. Executive. President. Executive Office. Cabinet. Legislature. Congress. Senate. Vice President. President pro tempore. House of Representatives. Speaker. Judiciary. Federal Judiciary. Supreme Court. Courts of Appeals. District Courts. Law. Constitution. Federalism. Preemption. Separation of Powers. Bill of Rights. Civil Liberties. Code of Federal Regulations. Federal Reporter. United States Code. United States Reports. Intelligence. Central Intelligence Agency. Defense Intelligence Agency. Federal Bureau of Investigation. National Geospatial Intelligence Agency. National Reconnaissance Office. National Security Agency. Office of the Director of National Intelligence. Uniformed Armed Forces. Army. Marine Corps. Navy.